Hey there, I am Parth Doshi, exploring the field of RPA and sharing my learnings with you by making videos. So this is the first video in which we are going to actually start learning and building workflows in UiPath Studio X. So in this video, we are going to see what activities provided by Studio X. So in this activity, we are going to see how we can add our own text in the Word document and how we can create a Word document using UiPath Studio X, and also how we can add a picture to that file. So without any delay, let's get started. Now, first thing which I have done is I have created a simple blank task called as Word activities. Once that is done, you will be redirected to this particular page. Okay. So now what we have to do is we are going to go to this Word activities. Okay. Now, the first thing to use any of the Word activities. Now, first let's understand what are activities. So when you perform some task in the layman language, the definition of activity is performing a small task. In the similar way, we are going to use, we have a set of activities over here that perform a small task for us. And a set of activities builds a complete process. So similarly, you can see on my left hand side, there are activities which we are going to use to build our complete process. So now, to use any of the Word activities, even if you want to insert text, read text, add the picture, replace text in the document, whatever you want to do, you need to use the Word document this. You need to first specify, use Word file. Because the system won't know directly which file you want to create. Maybe you want to create an Excel file. Maybe you want to create some other file, a TXT file or something else. So here we need to use the text called, the resource called use Word file. Now, first thing you can see there are, okay. So now the important thing are the properties. So the input we need to give is the file name. Now, there can be two ways of giving the input. One, you have an already created file on which you want to work, and one, you can create a new one. So create if not exist, you can always take it. There's no problem in like, you can always select it, keep it selected, because if the file won't exist, it will automatically create a file for you. So now you see browse for file. So if you have an already created file, you can go for browse for file, but if not, there are different options over here. You can see project notebook. The project notebook, I will make a proper detailed video on project notebook, but for now let's go with text. Also, you can give the input when you are actually running your workflow. So if you click on this, it will ask you when you run this particular workflow, but we don't want to do that. We want to give the text, which is going to be UiPath DevCon. Okay, so this, okay, and one mistake which we made over here is we didn't give the extension. It is always necessary, it is always mandatory to give the file extension. Okay, so it will create if it doesn't exist, and it will auto save. Save changes made to the document if not selected. Changes made when the project is run will not be saved. So it is always mandatory to select this as well, because we want to auto save our file. Now what we are going to do, you can see there are different actions that can be performed. Add picture, append text, insert data table. I will explain what is data table in later videos. Read text, replace picture, replace text in document, save document as. So there can be like, you have a template which we are using, and then you want to create different Word documents with different names. So for that you can use save document as, save document as PDF, set bookmark content. Right now what we are going to do is append. Append means we are going to write the text into that file. Now again, there are two options. Text, ask to enter and paste from clipboard. So if there is something copied from clipboard, open in advanced editor, project notebook. Again, to first, since we are just getting started with UiPath Studio X, I'm trying to keep the concepts as simple as I can. Text, so hey there, UI Okay, so let's write few hours to go for UI path virtual developer conference. Okay, so I think that's a good text. Few hours to go for UiPath virtual developer conference. Okay, and after that what we are going to do is we are going to add a picture. So you see there's an option add new line before text, insert a line break after existing text in the file. So it is used for that particular. Now browse file, again you see options. You can specify from here, from the project notebook. You can give the file path, you can manually type it, ask when run. Okay, but we are going to directly indicate our picture, which is over here. Okay, so you can see we have clicked on add picture. So now here you see the flow. We took each of the activities of Word and we built a complete process which will write the text and add the picture for us. That's very simple to understand. No complex things involved, and properties you can see each one of them have their properties. Input text, again over here the file path which we have provided, user folder, download creatives and the download thing. Okay, so now let's run our this. So now the complete process we have built, that is called a workflow in UiPath Studio X. So in this workflow what we have done is we have firstly specified that I want to use a Word file. After that we are writing the text by using append text activity, and then we are adding the picture. So let's run this and see whether we are able to get the required output or if we are getting any errors. Okay, so see, it opened the Word file, it saved, and it automatically closed for me. Now the process got perfectly executed, no problem in that. Okay, so let's open this file and see. Okay, so as you can see over here we have, and if you see, this is not a simple image, we added a GIF over here, GIF over here. And now you see why this one line over here, because here we had selected add new line before text. So by chance if you are using a previously created file and the text should not get overwritten. So selecting that particular feature is important, add new line before text. So I hope this video help you gain a clear understanding of how to use Word activities, what are activities in UiPath Studio X, how to use each of them, what is the flow required to build a complete process, and it helped you learn something new. Please do subscribe to my channel. Okay, before that let's do a quick recap of what we saw in this video. So in this video we saw what are activities, how to use activities, how to build a complete process. We saw how to write the text and append a picture and add a picture in our Word document. I will be coming up with more interesting use cases on Word activities as well as different activities. Stay tuned to my channel and press the bell icon to stay updated to all the new videos I upload. Thank you.